الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. Some of the people, they don't like when you talk about Tawheed. They get tired of hearing Tawheed. Is it all another lecture about Tawheed, another kalimat about Tawheed, another something about Tawheed? Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created mankind and jinn except for the purpose of worshipping me. So of course, yes, it's another talk about Tawheed. وَاللَّهُ مُسْتَعَانَ. And we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with good and protects us from evil, and blesses us with ikhlas, with thabat ala sunnah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds and forgive our evil deeds, and accept our fasting, accept our salat, and accept our zakat, and accept our those who are making, who will make hajj, and those who make umrah, and all their acts of ibadah. And may Allah help us to come back to the worship of Him and Him alone. Because that's what our life is, that's what we're here for. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I have not created mankind and jinn except for the purpose of worshipping me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Worship Allah alone and do not associate partners with Him. That's it. However, unfortunately, there are many Muslims who don't like that da'wah, or they redefine that da'wah. For some of our brothers and sisters in Islam, they say, hey, don't talk about Tawheed because you're going to divide the people. And that's exactly what the Quraysh said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it's a really shameful thing to have the Muslims have that same kind of da'wah, to where they say, don't speak about the oneness of Allah and worshiping Allah alone because it divides the people. Talk about something else. We can all relate to good manners. And good manners is from Islam and it's beautiful. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, مَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ أَثْقُلُ فِي مَيْزَانَ مُؤْمِنْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ حُسْنُ الْخُلْقِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبْغِذُ الْفَحِشَ الْبَدِيءَ. There isn't a thing on the Day of Judgment that weighs heavier on the scale of a believer than good manners. And verily, Allah hates sinful speech. That's from Islam. That weighs heavy on the scale of the believers. But not like Tawheed, not like the monotheism, not like worshiping Allah alone. That comes secondary. So although it's a part of our religion, our da'wah is not based on good manners only, but it's based on calling the people away from shirk, calling them from the dhulamat ila nur, calling them from the darkness to the light. The darkness being shirk and polytheism, worshipping Jesus, worshipping Moses, worshipping the angel Jibreel, worshipping the cow, worshipping the sun, the moon, the stars, and the fire. That's what dhulamat is. But nur is worshipping Allah. It's worshipping the one who created all of those things. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر واسجدوا لله الذي خلقهن إن كنتم إياه تعبدون. Allah says that from His signs, and look at the signs here, mashallah tabarakallah, min ayatihi al-layli wal-nahar, and from His signs is the night and the day. Here we are in the day, and let's look at the beautiful signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min ayatihi al-layli wal-nahar is the night and the day. وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ. Ah, the shams, there's the sun. The sun and the moon. لَا تَسْجِدُ لِلشَّمْسِ. Do not prostrate to the shams. And the shams is so magnificent in and of itself anyway. Allah created that. He's the creator of that. And the sun alone, I can't even point my camera up there. It'll distort the picture. So that shows you the power of the sun. And Allah created that. لَا تَسْجِدُ لِلشَّمْسِ وَلَا لِلْقَمَرِ. And do not worship the moon. Worship Allah, the one who created it, if it is Him who you worship. That's what the believer is for. And that's where our da'wah starts. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.